2010 is coming to a close, and we wanted to take a look back at some of the climate and weather events of the year. Here's our top five in chronological order. Of course, no one on the East Coast can forget Snowmageddon back in February. It stretched from Atlanta to D.C. to New York all the way to Europe. We can now point the finger at two natural climate patterns, the North Atlantic Oscillation, known as the NAO, and El Niño. The NAO refers to the atmospheric pressure difference between the subtropical high and the Icelandic low. When that difference is negative, the U.S. East Coast and Europe are cold. El Niño is the periodic warming of the Pacific Ocean off the coast of South America. And together, they acted like a 1-2 punch, with a very negative NAO allowing cold Arctic air to push south. And El Niño shifted the storm tracks to provide the moisture for all that snow. Moving on, in May, Nashville experienced a 1,000-year flood event. That's a flood that has just a 0.1% chance of happening in any given year. As the planet warms, these type of extreme downpours are expected to happen more often. In July, an epic heat wave gripped Russia. Wildfires tore across more than 2,900 square miles. At the same time, and most certainly connected in terms of atmospheric dynamics, an exceptionally strong monsoon flooded Pakistan, leaving entire villages submerged. Scientists continue to investigate the potential role of global warming in these two events. Finally, rounding out our top five is the record low level of Lake Mead, the major source of water for Las Vegas. The reservoir is just 8 feet shy of drought restrictions when water rationing would start. And the ongoing La Niña, which tends to lead to drier conditions across the U.S. Southwest, is not expected to help matters this winter. Check out our website for the complete top 10 list, and check back soon for another climate update.